Hi friends, welcome back to the channel Engineering Mathematics for Great Exam. Let us see some more practice questions on calculus. This video is very important because the questions in this video are based on the curves. Okay, the questions related to curves. We will see how to solve. Okay, basically this part is very important because so many students thought that after watching the question itself, it is complicated to find the limits or how to draw. I don't know. They may think that, okay, and may left the question. Okay. My motivation is to, after watching this video, every student who watched this video should be able to solve this question. Okay, so while solving the questions based on these curves lines, okay, basically very three important steps are there. Okay, first step is you have to draw the curve based on the given data itself. Okay, you need not to remember the curves, how to draw. Okay, those things is not required at all. Just based on the given data itself, given curve itself, how to draw, I will show you. Okay, clearly I will explain you how to draw the curve and how to find the intersection points of that curve with respect to lines. Okay, I will tell you the step by step procedure how to draw the curves based on the given lines and curves. Okay, and how to find the intersection points. That is the point number one. And point number two is you have to find the limits. Okay, in order to find the area or volume, you have to, in the integral, you have to find the limits. Okay, so I will tell you the step by step how to find the limits. Okay, based on the problem. And the third step is finding the required area or volume based on given problem. Okay, so these are the three very important steps. Remember, step by step if you solve, okay, if you remember these steps, okay, you can solve any question, and I will tell you step by step procedure how to solve this question. Sometimes the question may be asked to find the limits after interchanging the order of double integration. So in that case, it will end with second point itself, find the limits. Okay, after drawing the curve and lines, if you find the new limits, that will be end. Okay, with point number two, in case if the question is based on finding the limit after interchanging the order of double integration. Okay, now look at the question number one. See, the area bounded by the parabola 2y is equal to x square and the line x is equal to y minus 4 is equal to. It is asked to find the area bounded by the parabola 2y is equal to x square and the line x is equal to y minus 4. Okay, that is the question. And given the parabola is 2y is equal to x square and line x is equal to y minus 4. So friend, here 2y is equal to x square parabola is given. Now let us see how to draw the 2y equal to x square. Okay, first friends, draw the y and x plane. Okay, y and x plane. So after drawing the y and x plane, see here it is 2y equal to x square. So for every value of x, it may be positive or negative, you will get only positive value of y because of x is in square nature. Okay, so for positive values of x and for negative values of x, you will get only positive values of y. So y will be in positive coordinates only. If you take this as 0, 0, from here it will be positive y, here it will be negative y, and it will be positive x, it will be negative x. So for positive x, negative x, you will get only positive. So the curve will be like this: at x is equal to 0, y equal to 0. So it will pass through 0, 0. So it will pass through 0, 0, and positive values of x and negative values of x, you will get only positive value of y. That means it will be in the above coordinate only. So draw the curve which is passing through 0, 0. Okay friends, I hope you got how to draw the 2y equal to x square. This is the procedure to draw the 2y is equal to x square. Okay, so that's it. Okay, next, finding the intersection points. Okay, so from the given equation itself, you can find the x and y values. Sometimes friends, in question they will give the intersection points, so at that time using intersection points you can draw the lines. Okay, but here the line is given, so you have to find the intersection points based on these equations. Okay, 2y equal to x square and x is equal to y minus 4. So substitute y minus 4 here. So 2y is equal to y minus 4 square. That is equal to 2y is equal to y square minus 8y plus 16. So that is equal to, if you take this 2y this side, so y square minus 10y plus 16 is equal to 0. Okay, so y square is equal to, you can write 10y as 8y, 2y, okay, plus 16. So that is equal to, if you take y outside, so y into y minus 8, if you take minus 2 outside, minus 2 into y minus 8, that is equal to 0. So y is equal to 2 comma 8. Okay, so you got the y values. Now we have to find the x values. So using this equation, x is equal to y minus 4, substitute y values. So at y is equal to 2, x is equal to 2 minus 4, that will be x is equal to minus 2. And at y is equal to 8, x is equal to y minus 4, so 8 minus 4, that is x is equal to 4. So x limits is minus 2, 4. So at minus 2, y value is 2, and at x is equal to 4, y is 8. Okay, so friends, in this curve, minus 2 comma 2 will be this point. Okay, if you take approximately, you have to draw. Okay friends, so here it is minus x coordinate, so minus 2 will be here, so minus 2, and y line is this positive y, so positive y will be 2 will be here, so that point, intersection point is this one, minus 2 comma 2. And at x is equal to 4, y is equal to 8. Let us take this point as, for x is equal to 4, y is equal to 8. Okay, so these two are the points. So you have to draw the line passing through these two points. Okay, I hope you understand friends. If you have any doubts, ask me in the comment section. Okay, so draw the line which is passing through minus 2 comma 2 and 4 comma 8. So that's it. This is the region we have to find the area. Okay, so area is equal to minus 2 comma 4, okay, and this line, this is x is equal to y minus 4 line, so x is, so y will be x plus 4, okay, minus this curve, y 2y is equal to x square, so y is equal to x square by 2, so area will be x minus 4 minus x plus 4 minus x square, okay, integral x limits minus 2 to 4 dx. So that is equal to integral of x is nothing but x square by 2 plus 4x minus x cube by 6, okay, limits minus 2 to 4. So if you substitute the limits, 16 by 2 plus 16 minus 4 cube by 6 minus 4 by 2 minus 8 plus minus 2 cube is nothing but minus 8, so here minus already there, so plus 8 by 6, so that will 8 plus 16 minus 32 by 3 minus 2 minus 8 plus 4 by 3, so that is equal to 30 minus 36 by 3, so that is equal to 90 minus 36 by 3, that is equal to 54 by 3, so that is equal to area is 18. I hope you understand friends. Okay, first we have draw the curve based on the given data, and after that we have find the intersection points, okay, based on the given line and curve, okay, and we have find the intersection points, and based on the intersection points we have drawn that line, okay, passing through those two points, okay, on the curve, and we found the area. Okay, this is the procedure to find the area of the curve. Okay, now look at question number 2. By reversing the order of integration, integral of 0 to 2, integral of x squared 2x, f of x comma dy dx may be represented as. Now we have to find the new limits after interchanging the order of integration. This question already I have told, but again, another question I am telling in just for practice purpose, okay. You have to understand this also, okay. You will get the confidence to solve any question based on this, okay. Order of integration also, okay. Now look at, given 0 to 2 and x squared to 2x, f of x comma y dy dx is given. So this is limits of y, okay, it is in terms of x, so it will be y equal to x squared, y equal to 2x, so y equal to x squared, y equal to 2x, and these are the limits of x, so x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 2. Okay, so friends, now first you have to First point, you have to draw the curve. Okay, so y equal to x square. So for any value of x positive or negative, you will get y because x is square in nature. So and at x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0. So it will pass, the curve will pass 0, 0. And for positive values or negative values of x, you will get positive y. So this is the curve, okay? For positive or negative values of x, you are getting positive values of y only. So, and it is passing through 0, 0. So this is the curve, okay? Now, given x is equal to 0. So at x is equal to 0, after substituting x value in this y equal to 2x, y is also 0, okay? And at x is equal to 2, y is equal to 2x, so 2 into 2, 4. Okay. So we got the limits. Okay. So now draw this line. Okay. It is the 0, 0. Okay. And at x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4. This is the point. At x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4. This is the point. So the line which is passing through 0, 0 and 2, 4. Draw this line. Okay. I hope you got the friends. Okay. So now here we are interchanging the order of integration. That means now it is given dy dx, so after that we have to find the limits for dx dy. So for dx we have to find the limits. That means take the horizontal strip. I have told you already, friends. So take the horizontal strip in this region. So for this horizontal strip, the x limits will be at y equal to 2x, so this line. So x is equal to y by 2. Okay. And it is end with this curve. So the curve is y equal to x square. So x is equal to square root of y. I hope you got the friends. X is equal to y to x is equal to root y. It is varying based on this horizontal strip in this region. If you take horizontal strip in this region anywhere, in the top or bottom, okay, the limits will be x is equal to y by 2 to x is equal to square root of y. And for this horizontal strip, y is varying from 0 to 4. Okay. So y limits will be 0 to 4. So integral of 0 to 4, integral of y by 2 to square root of y, f of x comma y, dx dy. That is the answer. After interchanging the, after reversing the order of integration, okay, the new, it will be represented as 0 to 4 integral of 0 to 4 integral of y by 2 to square root of y f of x comma y dx dy. So here we are end with the second point. We have drawn the curve and we have find the intersection points, that is point number 1, and we have found the new limits. It is end here. In case if it is asked you to find the area or integration, third step will come. Okay, so remember these three steps. Only based on these three steps you can solve any question, okay, on this curve, based on the curve in calculus. Okay, now look at the question number 3. The area enclosed between the parabola y is equal to x square and the straight line y is equal to x. Okay, so here parabola is given and line is given. We have to find the area. Okay, so as per the step 1, first draw the curve and line. Okay, so first to draw the curve y equal to x square. So first to take x and y coordinates. First to draw x and y line. Okay, coordinates. After that, the parabola y equal to x square. So for every positive or negative value of x, we are getting positive y. So for in this xy coordinates, this will be positive x and here it will be negative x. But here it will be positive y and here it will be positive y, means upper portion of this y coordinate, and here it is positive and here it is, x is positive, here x is negative. So and at x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0. Okay, so the curve must be in this coordinate and in this coordinate, and it will pass through 0, 0. So draw the curve. Okay, draw the curve from x positive x and positive y to negative x positive y and passes through 0, 0. So this will be the curve. Okay, I hope you got, friends. If you have any doubt, please ask me in the comment section. Okay, this will be the curve now. Now, in order to draw the line, first we have to find the intersection points. So, using y equal to x square, okay, and y is equal to x. So, substitute x. So, x is equal. So, that means x square minus x is equal to 0. Okay. So, that will be x into x minus 1 is equal to 0. So, x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1. So, at x is equal to 0, y will be 0. And at x is equal to 1, y is also 1. Okay. So, the line must pass through 0, 0 and 1, 1. So, if you take this point as 1 for x coordinate and this will be y, 1 for y coordinates. So, if this is the point and it is the 0, 0 point. So, line must pass through these two points. So, draw the line which is passes through 0, 0 and 1, 1 and intersect with this curve. Okay. Now, area. Okay. Here we have to find the limits. We already got these points and we have to find the area. So directly integral of 0 to 1 this line x minus x square dx. Okay, so that is equal to x integration x square by 2 and x square integration x cube by 3 and limits 0 to 1. So that is equal to 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 and minus 0 by 2 0 0 by 3 0. Okay, so minus 0. So area is equal to 3 minus 2 by 6 2 into 3. So that is equal to 1 by 6. Okay, 1 by 6 is the area for this problem. Now look at the question number 4. Changing the order of integration in the double integral I is equal to integral 0 to 8 and x by 4 to 2 f of x comma y dy dx leads to I equal to integral of r to s and integral of p to q f of x comma y dx dy. So what is q? So here we have to find the new limits after changing the order of double integration. Here it is dy dx. Now we have to find new limits for dx dy. Okay. So I have already given the example, but again we will see one more question on how to find the new limits for after interchanging the order of integration so that you will get confidence and you will can solve the question with faster manner. Okay, so the given integral is I is equal to integral of 0 to a integral of x by 4 to 2 f of x comma y dy dx. So that is equal to, so the given limits here it is x by 4, that means it is y, here it is dy, so it is y limit. So y is equal to x by 4 and y is equal to 2 and here it is x is equal to 0 and x is equal to a. So draw the xy coordinates and draw y equal to x by 4 line. Okay, this will be the x by 4 line. Okay, so here it is y equal to 2, so y equal to 2, draw the y equal to 2 line and here this point will be 8 comma 2. Okay, so we have to find the dx dy. So first we have to find dx x limit. So here in this case we have to take the horizontal strip. This is the horizontal strip, friends. Okay, so for this based on this horizontal strip x limits is x is equal to 0 to x is equal to this line, that means x is equal to 4y. Okay, x is equal to 0, x is equal to 4y, that will, this is the new limits for x. And for this horizontal strip y is varying from 0 to 2. Okay, so the limits are y equal to 0 to 2. So integral of 0 to 2 y limits and x limits 0 to 4y f of x comma y dx dy. And that is equal to integral of rs, integral of pq, f of x comma y, dx, dy. So, q is 4y. That is the answer. Now, look at question number 5. If x comma y is continuous function defined over x comma y in 0 comma 1, 0 comma 1, given the constraints, given two constraints, that is x greater than y square and y greater than x square, so the volume under the f of x comma y is, okay, so given x greater than y square and y greater than x square, so first draw the curves in the xy coordinates. Take xy coordinate take xy coordinate, and first is y x square. So for every positive negative value of x, y is positive. So this is the curve, and which is f. At y x is equal to 0, y is 0. Okay. So this will be the curve. And for x greater than y squared, that means for every positive negative value of y, x is positive. So that will be in this coordinate only. X positive coordinate, but y positive negative. So this will be the curve. Okay. And now find the limits. In order to find the limits, take the horizontal strip. For volume, we have to find the limits x and y. So first take the horizontal strip for y coordinate. So y equal to x square. So from that, x is equal to root y. And next is x is equal to y square. Okay, so limits are for x is root y to y square. And for y limits, if you take this as, and the, this is the horizontal strip. So for this x, y is from 0 to 1. Okay. That is given already. Interval is given 0 to 1. So it is y limits will be 0 to 1. So volume is equal to integral of 0 to 1 into x is equal to y square to x is equal to root y f of x comma y dx dy. So look at the given options. So given x greater than y square and y greater than x square. So first draw the curves in the xy coordinates. Take xy coordinate. Take xy coordinate, and first is y x square. So for every positive negative value of x, y is positive. So this is the curve, and which is f. At y, x is equal to 0, y is 0. Okay. So this will be the curve. And for x greater than y squared, that means for every positive negative value of y, x is positive. So that will be in this coordinate only. X positive coordinate, but y positive negative. So this will be the curve. Okay. And now find the limits. In order to find the limits, take the horizontal strip. For volume, we have to find the limits x and y. So first take the horizontal strip for y coordinate. So y equal to x square. So from that, x is equal to root y. And next is x is equal to y square. Okay, so limits are for x is root y to y square. And for y limits, if you take this as, and the, this is the horizontal strip. So for this x, y is from 0 to 1. Okay. That is given already. Interval is given 0 to 1. So it is y limits will be 0 to 1. So volume is equal to integral of 0 to 1 into x is equal to y square to x is equal to root y f of x comma y dx dy. So look at the given options. Integral of y equal to 0 to 1. Integral of x is equal to y square to root y f of x comma y dx dy. So option A is correct. Now look at the question number 6. The area enclosed between the curves y square is equal to 4x and y square is equal to 4y is. Now two parabolas are given. So we have to find the area bounded by these two parabolas. So given y square is equal to 4x and y x square is equal to 4y. So draw the curves in xy coordinates. First point, so take xy coordinates. So in the xy coordinates, x square is equal to 4y. So positive negative values of x, only positive values of y. So this will be the curve, and at x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0. So the curve is passes through 0, 0, and for positive negative values of x, only positive values of y. So this is the curve. And y square is equal to 4x. That means for positive negative value of y, values of y, x is always positive. So this is the positive coordinate for x. So for positive or negative values of y, positive x. Okay, and at x is equal to 0, y equal to 0. So it is also passes through 0, 0. So draw the curve. Okay, now find this point of intersection using these two equations. So y square is equal to 4x and x square is equal to 4y. So substitute x is equal to y square by 4 in this. So y square by 4 whole square is equal to 4y. So that is equal to y power 4 by 16, that is equal to 4y. So y power 4 is equal to 64y. So y power 4 minus 64y is equal to 0. So y is equal to 0 and y cube is equal to 64. That means 4. So y is equal to 0, y equal to 4. And for at x is, at y is equal to 0, x is equal to 0. And at a, y is equal to 4, x is also 4, because x square is equal to 4 into 4. So x is 4. So the point of intersection is 4, 4. I hope you got, friends. Okay, so area is equal to integral of 0 to 4, and from here y is equal to square root of 4x, that means 2 root x. So 2 root x minus x square by 4, okay, dx. So that is equal to integrate this. So 2 into x power 1 by 2 is nothing but x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So x power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 minus x square. So x cube by 3 into 4 and 0 to 4 limits. So after substituting the limits, here it will be, if you take 3 by 2 upper side, so 4 by 3 into 4, 3 by 2, that will be 8 minus 4 into 4 into 4 divided by 3 into 4, 4, 4 get cancels. So 4, 4 into 4, 62. Here 8 into 4, 32 by 3 minus 16 by 3, that is equal to 16 by 3. So 16 by 3 is the answer. Now look at the question number 7. The volume under the surface z of x, y is equal to x plus y, and above the triangle in the xy plane defined by the x, y is varying from 0 to x and x is varying from 0 to 12 is. Okay, so given z of x is equal to x plus y, and y limits are 0 to x and x limits are 0 to 12. Okay, so here function is already given, so directly you have to, and the limits are also directly given. Here we no need to find the points of intersection or limits, anything. Okay, directly take this limits, x limits 0 to 12 and y limits 0 to x, z of x comma y dy dx, because these are the y limits. So dy dx and integrate it. Friends, here double integration is coming because of volume we are finding. Okay, for area we will get only one integral. Okay, so this integral means we will get area, and integration of area we will get volume. That is the concept of integration. Okay, suppose in some cases while solving the volume problem, you may get by given data, you may calculate directly area. At that case, directly find the area using given data and integrate it one time. So that will be sufficient. Okay. Here we are finding the area using integration itself. So integration for area and another integration for volume. Okay. So that is equal to integral 0 to 12, 0 to x, z of xy is nothing but x plus y dy dx. So that is equal to integral 0 to 12, integrate it with respect to y first. So xy plus y square by 2, limits 0 to x. So after substituting the x, limits 0 to 12, x into y, after replacing y with x, x square plus x square by 2 dx. So that is equal to integrate this. So x cube by 3 plus x cube by 2 into 3, 6, that way. So limits 0 to 12. So if you take 1 by 3 outside, x cube plus x cube by 2, 0 to 12, that means 3 by 2 x cube. So 1 by 3 into 3 by 2 into 12 into 12 into 12, and 0 will be 0 after substituting 0. Okay, so 3 3 get cancelled and 2 here 6 times, so 12 into 12 into 6, that is 864. So 864 is the answer. Friends, I hope you understand the concept of how to solve the problems on based on curves. Okay, if you have any doubts, please ask me in the comment section. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe my channel for more videos.